Welcome back. Well, the brand new British PM is fighting back calls to resign already over a series of policy U-turns critics say have shredded her credibility.
Former politician Nigel Farage joins us now live from London. Nice to see you this morning. Look, Liz Truss has only been in the job for 6 weeks. It has been disastrous.
Yes, catastrophic, I think, would be a better word. And bear in mind, against the background of this, we have now had, wait for it, 4 chancellors of the Exchequer in 4 months. I mean, it literally beggars belief. Liz Truss came in, she was elected with a very clear majority of the majority of Conservative Party members. She said she'd reduce the size of a state and she'd reduce taxation. Now, the mini-budget she and her Chancellor put up, maybe it went too far too fast, but what she really got punished for, she really got punished for reducing taxation. Now, what was interesting is where the attacks came from. They came from the IMF, they've come from Joe Biden, they've come from the German Chancellor, and I'm going to say this was an all-out globalist attack, because it seems that when our leaders get together at G20 meetings and all the rest of it, they're all agreed the state must get bigger and taxes must not fall. So there's something in me that says even if she got her messaging slightly wrong, her timing slightly out, I do feel a little bit sorry for her.
Well, no doubt. I mean, she has been elected based on all those premises. And they've slowly been eroded. I mean, even the Chancellor coming out and winding back the cap on energy prices. I mean, I saw this morning a whole bunch of interviews from very poor people who thought that was a great thing for their families, and now they've got a budget in another way.
Yes, I mean, the outcome of that is uncertain. What he has said is it'll stay till April and then all things are up for grabs. But we've been through 20 years of low growth. I mean, our productivity is lower than the French. But I never thought the French worked. I can't believe it. So we are, well, not after lunch anyway. So we really are in a bit of a mess. And what she was trying to do was to turn this around with a different message. And frankly, Jeremy Hunt today, what he did was the equivalent of a Labour Chancellor of the Exchequer, and the biggest kick in the teeth has come from the small companies, the self-employed, and they're going to see some very big tax rises. And I just think on the verge of a recession, what you don't do is discourage small business investment. So I think what's happened is very retrograde, very bad, and I suspect that the UK is in for a very long, cold, hard winter. But the Conservative Party has now split down the middle. The Brexit wounds simply haven't healed. We're heading for a Labour government. And tonight's polling, almost unbelievably, puts Labour 36 points ahead.
Wow.
That's the biggest lead. It's the biggest lead that's ever been seen between the two major parties in general election polling. So, yeah, a long, cold, tough winter. The lights could even go out in February, so badly have the Conservatives handled our energy supply policy. Big Labour majority coming whenever the next election is. It's not supposed to be for 2 years, but there comes a point when the public and the press say enough of this never-ending soap opera, this ridiculous circus that is the Conservative Party, it's time the people had their say. And I just get the feeling...
Hang on, Nigel. Yeah. I need to bring this up with you. Her position is so clearly on an edge, it sparked this question. Can Liz Truss outlast the 10-day shelf life of a lettuce? Look at this. Nigel, who are we backing here, Liz or the lettuce? This is a legit story. That's it. That's on the interweb right there. Who's going to survive?
Oh, my money's on the lettuce. Make no doubt about that.
Good to talk to you, Nigel. Thank you so much. I have a feeling it's not going to be the last time, but I always appreciate your time.